Hi, everyone. Welcome to the Hybrid Cloud and Edge digital event. My name is Lior Kamrat, and I'm a principal product manager as part of the Azure Arc platform team. I have my friend with me, Sarah. Sarah, how are you doing?
Hey, I'm doing well, Lior. Yeah, I'm Sarah Cooley. I'm a program manager on the AKS on-premises team.
So, Sarah, today we're here to talk about everything that is Azure Arc, hybrid, how everything fits together. That's part of the, you know, this entire day that we are having. But specifically, you and I, we wanted to talk about something that is very focused around how do we actually address in hybrid application development patterns in the world of hybrid and Azure Arc. So, Sarah, really, to kick us off, walk me through the vision, how we are actually looking at this.
Of course, in order to run an app successfully, part of development and part of growing the application is going to be having the right ecosystem of tools to run in a hybrid way with all of the right integrated services and infrastructure to support that app and development patterns. So we're going to be talking a lot about our end-to-end hybrid stack across Azure, Azure Arc, and our on-premise solutions, so that you can run your app and develop it continuously at scale and keep it going through day two.
All right. So I think, Sarah, you know, this is really an interesting space, and Arc and hybrid in general and everything that is HCI as part of it. It's really a big, you know, it's really a big topic. There is a lot of ground to cover. So I think that, you know, this whole notion of hybrid application development patterns is really interesting because it really shows how everything, all these building blocks are fitting together. So, you know, I wanna really to talk to the audience about for a second and level set about Azure Arc and what this is all about. So Azure Arc, if you're thinking about this, Azure Arc is really about stretching our control plane. Stretching our control plane means that we are taking the operating system of Azure, Azure Resource Manager, and bringing that or stretching that to your own environment. Now, Azure Arc is really kind of a bi-directional thing. If you're thinking about that, we have Azure Arc-enabled infrastructure, which is all about projecting resources or IT assets that are deployed outside of Azure and bring those into Azure. So those assets can be either servers or SQL servers or Kubernetes clusters, which is something that we're going to talk about today a lot, and also Azure Arc-enabled services. So those Azure Arc-enabled services are you know, really about taking those services that we have today in Azure and being able to deploy those on top of Kubernetes clusters that are deployed outside of Azure. So that's really the bidirectional aspect of Azure Arc. And what we want to talk about today is about how do you take those services and harvest the power of platform as a service solutions like Azure Arc-enabled SQL Managed Instance, or Key Vault integrations, or you know, Kubernetes clusters, and how do you actually take those and leveraging those to your application development patterns? So, Sarah, that's what we're going to talk about today, right?
Sure is.
Okay, so to really start diving into the architecture, Sarah, talk to me for a second about the first building block that we need to take under consideration.
Yeah, so for better or worse, everything gets to start with an infrastructure layer because all of this stuff needs somewhere to run. So looking at picking the on-premise infrastructure or the cloud infrastructure that's actually going to be running Kubernetes, we have a ton of options. So I work on AKS on-prem, so I'm particularly fond of AKS on HCI and Windows Server. However, Arc supports any CNCF Kubernetes solution. So you can run even AKS in the cloud if you wanted to, but GKE, EKS, EKS Anywhere, OpenShift, Tanzu, lots of options today. And one of the things that's nice about having an integrated stack, so as I said, I work on AKS on-prem, we've helped simplify a lot of that deployment and day two management experience, especially on a multi-node cluster, to make it so that your infrastructure can kind of disappear into the background. Ideally, in a perfect world, you would never need to think about this layer. So it's nice being able to have a quick deployment experience, easy update experiences, as well as some prorated services and single provider solution support. We also do version matching with Kubernetes in AKS so that you have a really slick, validated end-to-end cloud hybrid experience. But you are going to need to start by picking your favorite infrastructure or whatever you have running Kubernetes today, and then you get to connect that to Arc.
So, Sarah, I mean, the connection to Arc, which is Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes that we're seeing here, that's really kind of the start of building this foundation towards a hybrid application pattern, right? Mm-hmm. Because we talked about the notion of having, okay, you can pick and choose whatever Kubernetes distribution that may be. We have the validation program just to make sure that we are getting our stamp of approval on top of those distribution. So why do I need to start with Azure Arc enabled Kubernetes? Why is it so important for me to think about that as I'm starting to think about my development pattern?
Yeah, so you started. We started this demo or this walkthrough talking a little bit about how Arc lets you stretch things from on-premise, your application, out into the cloud. Also, it lets you move from the cloud to on-premise. So what Arc-enabled Kubernetes does is it makes it so you can connect your Kubernetes target clusters to Azure and easily integrate Azure solutions like Azure Key Vault, Azure Monitor. If you are using something like Azure Container Registry, take those artifacts that you're using to support your application in the cloud and make sure that you can use them on-premise as well in a way that's compatible and consistent. So we find that it's really, really important to be able to always rely on GitHub and GitOps for end-to-end development. So that Azure Arc and connecting your clusters to Arc is a layer that gives you that consistency between the cloud and on-prem or another multi-cloud vendor, no matter where you're running. So wherever that Kubernetes cluster is running, by connecting it to Arc, you have a consistent set of experiences for those target clusters, no matter where they are running.
Okay, so shifting gears, we want to talk today about why is it so important for us to think about hybrid application development patterns in the context of Azure Arc. So you mentioned you mentioned GitOps, and before we're going to touch on GitOps, which is very important in that sense, we wanted to take a sample application and maybe just kind of go through a journey when it comes to that sample application. So in this example, we have a bookstore application. This is a critical application that is designed to be deployed in multiple retail locations as part of an organization development cycle, right? So that bookstore application in this example is a microservices application that is written in a distributed fashion, specifically in this case in Go language. And that's the first building block when it comes to your application, right? Because, okay, so this is what I'm about to deploy. Now, what I wanna talk about here, Sarah, is how does that fit into the notion of Azure Arc and the notion of hybrid application patterns? So really to start thinking about this, I'm showing here the first extension, which is the Flux cluster extension. Now, I want to also take a step back, Sarah, and just kind of explain to our viewers that there is something called the Azure Arc extensibility model, right? And that extensibility model is very important because that extensibility model allows us to install different extensions for different purposes on top of that, those Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes clusters, right? And the way that we are doing this is by basically creating this relationship between a certain technology, right? In this case, I'm showing GitOps, which we're going to talk about in a second here, and into our application. How does that fit into that application universe, okay? So the Flux cluster extension for GitOps, that's the first block when it comes to our application. So let's talk about for a second about what is really GitOps in the sense of our application and start connecting the dots. So the first thing that you want to think about in this concept of hybrid application development pattern is the fact that, like you mentioned, Sarah, you have a Git repository, right? And that doesn't have to be on GitHub. It can be on Bitbucket or it can be on premises. Like, it doesn't really matter, right? But at the end of the day, you have a Git repository. In this case, we're showing GitHub just as an example, that is acting as the source of truth, right? That source of truth really holds how the application is going to look like in a Kubernetes environment, okay? Now, because we Arc enabled that Kubernetes cluster, and again, it can be any Kubernetes distribution that may be that is sitting on premises or in a multi-cloud environment, that Kubernetes environment is now connected to our Git repository via that Flux extension, right? So in the backend, we're deploying those operators, and basically that extension is now listening to that Git repository. Now, what is happening also is that once the Flux operator is starting to listen to that Git repository, at that point, what we can do is we can basically deploy the application at scale because now the extension knows that hey, this is how the application should look like, and please go ahead and deploy that. So that's the Flux operator that is initiating that process, okay? So now that the application is deployed and it's reflecting what is currently in the Git repository with the same configuration, security, RBAC, everything that's got to do with that. Now, the second piece that I want to bring up, again, we're talking about development patterns, right? So a lot of the time in development patterns, we're also talking about, okay, so how do I actually test versioning in my application? So another good extension, again, remember, we're talking about the extensibility model here in the context of this development pattern, right? So another good extension to bring up is the Open Service Mesh or OSM cluster extension. That extension is basically our own implementation to a service mesh technology, and service mesh technology is bringing a lot to the table. So what I want to emphasize here is one pattern that, or one capability that is part of service mesh architecture, and that's really the notion of versioning or blue-green traffic routing. So we can think about the situation where we have the application, but now we want to test version 2 of the application. So as part of the GitOps process, we already deployed the application. That's version 1. That's the source of truth. But now we want to test version 2, and we want to see how it behaves when we're starting to route traffic towards that application. So using the Open Service Mesh cluster extension, we can also leverage GitOps as part of that. So you can start to see, Sarah, how things are jelloing, starting to merge together, okay? So what we're doing as part of that, we're also basically targeting that Git repository also for a traffic policy, basically YAML file, that will basically define how we want to manipulate the traffic that goes into that application. So the way to do that is via that policy, and we're defining, okay, a certain amount of or X amount of traffic will go via percentage, right? Will go into version 1, and the second piece will go into version 2, okay? Or the second or the rest of the traffic will go into version 2. So what we're doing is we're testing the functionality of version 2, and as a developer or as a DevOps engineer, you can control, okay, so now that I know that version 2 is functioning, I'm going to route the rest of the traffic into that application. So you can start seeing how things are starting to jello in the sense of this hybrid application pattern. The third piece, Sarah, that I wanted to talk to you about is secrets management. And how does that look like? So secrets management is also a concept that is very much, you know, everyone aware of that. Everyone knows that it's there. Everyone knows that security is important. There's nothing new under the sun there. But here's another extension that we're bringing to the table, which is the Azure Key Vault extension, or AKV. That cluster extension, again, deployed and installed in the same way that we installed the other extensions, is responsible for secrets and certificates and secrets management via Key Vault, right? So again, the application, the bookstore application, can now basically use that extension or harvest the technology that that extension is bringing to the table and use that for certificate and secrets management as part of the process. And everything is happening automatically because the extension is already there. It's already configured against the Azure Key Vault that is in the environment. And that's it. You know, all the developer needs to do is to make sure that the application is actually targeting that Key Vault and being able to pull those secrets. So that's the third extension. And the fourth piece that I want to bring in, Sarah, before we're talking about, like, how does that fit together into the hybrid story, right? What is it that is so unique about this is the Azure Arc data services cluster extension. So Azure Arc enabled data services is one of our, you know, hero offerings when it comes to the Azure Arc portfolio. Azure Arc is a set of technologies. Data services is a big part of that. And what we're able to do with that is we're able to bring data services into your own environment. So Sarah, you talked about the notion of having, you know, multiple Kubernetes clusters and all that. So the power of that extension is really being able to allow the developer to deploy either SQL managed instance or PostgreSQL on top of those Kubernetes clusters that, again, are not deployed in Azure. Now, once you have that, once you have those deployed on the cluster, what can happen is that you can use, or the developer can use in his application, the data services as the backend for the data that is part of the overall application structure and architecture. So in this case, we're showing Azure Arc enabled SQL managed instance and as the backend database, which is used by the application. So Sarah, I talked a lot about the pattern that we're seeing here, and what I wanna ask you here, Sarah, is how do we want to think about how everything fits together? Like, because we're talking a lot about unified operations, so talk to me about that for a second.
Yeah. Oh, and thank you for walking through all of the app patterns, because at the end of the day, that's what folks really care about. So once you've gone through and you have your Kubernetes cluster and you're tying all of the requirements you have to be able to do development on your application together with Azure Key Vault and Open Service Mesh and using traffic policy to be able to iterate on the app, as you go through that story, it's all unified with a single control plane experience that gives you unified governance and unified management through a combination of Arc and all of the tools available as part of that tool chain. To me, this unified operations management is especially interesting and important when you look at Azure Policy and Azure Monitor, because as you have your app running and growing over time, you can use AED RBAC to manage policies so that your administrators have a set of things that they can do, and your developers don't necessarily need to be blocked on administrators because you have the right roles and permissions to maintain a unified, secure environment through the lifetime of your application. Diving a little bit back down as we're talking a bit more about the continuous deployed app lifecycle as you grow and scale, this is really where you start seeing the value of having something like AKS on premises or using our enabled Kubernetes, because then you're going to have a tightly managed application with real roles and permissions that are held together through AAD, RBAC, and Azure Policy, Azure Monitor. So you can use tools like Lighthouse to make sure that you are continuously monitoring and maintaining security across your application, even while developers are continuing to iterate, while also being able to scale your solution. So you have auto scale and the ability to increase the size of those workloads as you need to allow your application to grow and be maintained at scale. So I really love this unified control plane, as you can see and monitor and manage your app with, as I said, Azure Monitor, Azure Policy, RBAC via Lighthouse. So that's role-based access controls enforced via Lighthouse. And using Azure Defender for Kubernetes to continuously maintain security at, way beyond the first day and deployment of the application. So that's really exciting to me because in some ways, once an app is deployed, it's easy to be like, great, we've done our jobs. But then you have to be able to grow and maintain that. So it's really a nice end-to-end hybrid story for folks who are looking for a solution that they can grow and maintain over time past day one, too.
So Sarah, thank you for walking me through this. And I know that you're involved with many customers and so on, talking about this stuff and trying to understand how our customers are actually using this type of technology. And I really like the notion that you brought, that is the Azure Policy, because that really brings the scale game, right, into reality. You know, at the end of the day, we can deploy all these extensions and we can, you know, show all these patterns, but the scale is really what, you know, where everything clicks. It's where you want to show that we can do this, you know, not just for one or two Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes clusters, but we want to show how we can do this at scale.
Yeah, you really don't want to need to re-architect your app as it grows. Like, ideally, you deploy an app and it would be successful and you're going to be continuously growing that and continuously maintaining that. And all of these tools reduce friction. Like, they make it possible to, without needing to go through a major overhaul, maintain and grow that application over time. So I'm really excited about it, about the entire end-to-end structure. And I hope you are too.
So Sarah, thank you so much for joining me for this great session. We like to keep it short and sweet. We love for those sessions to be right on point. And thank you so much for helping me delivering that message. And thank you so much for our viewers as part of this hybrid cloud and edge digital event. Sarah, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me. Happy development.
Bye, everyone.